Now, along the way through all of this, all of us are having our own questions and our own discussions individually with this man from Egypt. The Catholic priest asked him one day, "Can I go to your church with you?" His temple, his mosque. He said, "Sure, come on." They were gone for a while. They got back a little later. We took the priest aside. We said, "Did you go in there?" "Yeah." "Did you see them?" "Yeah." "What do they do?" "Do they like slaughter little animals or anything like that?" Or, you know. He said, "No, actually, they stand there like monks do. You know, in monks in a monastery, they stand for hours praying." He said, "That's what they do. They just stand there and pray. And then they bow. And they do something that only the high priest gets to do, which is to put a sajda or prostration." I said, "Really?" He said, "Yeah." "And then what?" "And then they leave." "That's it?" "Yeah." "Okay. What kind of music do they have?" He said, "They don't have any music." "How in the world do you worship God without music? I was a music minister. Hello." So I went to my friend from Egypt. I said, "Excuse me, is it true you guys don't have any music in your mosques?" He said, "That's true." "How many mosques are in the world?" He said, "Millions." I said, "Millions? They all have electricity?" He said, "Yeah." Because I sell electric pianos, organs. I was thinking, I could get rich. This is a good idea. "You think they'd be interested in any music?" He said, "You could try." "But I doubt it." "You boy." See, he didn't want to make anything just like haram, haram, haram. Just let you get in the door. First thing first, la ilaha illallah. And he kept that first no matter what we brought up. No matter what was the subject, he get it back to la ilaha illallah. A few days more go by. The Catholic priest says, "Can I go again with you?" He said, "Sure." He said, "I found such peace there. I just want to go there again and feel that feeling again." So they left. And they didn't come back. They didn't come back. And it was so late at night. And they finally drove up the old country road out there. And when they got out of the car, right away I recognized the Muslim, you know. But who was this guy with him? Had on a white kufiya, a long white robe. I said, "That's the priest?" "What happened to you? Pete, did you become a Muslim?" He said, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah." I was shocked. I considered this to be the biggest part of the story because this man had dedicated his entire life to the Lord. He had completely given up all worldly things so that he could be a priest. He could not get married. He could not have children. He cannot do this and that and so and so. They don't even gamble. They don't do anything. They just pray. So, "Wow, you giving all that up?" He said, "I'm giving up nothing. I'm gaining." I'm going, "Really?" He said, "This is the right way." I said, "I know it is." So let me get my cameras out. We used to have a television show. I get my camera out, set it on a tripod, get the lights hooked up, put the microphones in. You guys know how long that takes. We get it all together. Guess what? The priest was asleep.